Ray Fresh killing the beat.
News facts, and shit like that.
Facts, bro. Facts.
So yeah, man. So on to
what's next?
On to the messy news, next? Man, and the entertainment news. This shit is getting out of hand, man. So King Von, the demon of Chicago, the serial killer, the Chicago serial killer, they got footage of this dude. Somebody came out, and before I play this footage, I think that these police or COs or whatever are putting this footage out, because whoever is running this page, shouts out to Rax Raris. He went up. This dude, he just made his page recently, and he's been dropping all his content on all these Chicago rappers, body cam footage of them, whether they're telling or getting into fights. And this video that just now came out that started all of this, that went viral, was a video of King Von telling the guards that he wanted to go PC because of his sexual orientation.
That's crazy, nigga.
So
that's
he's claiming in the video, he's claiming that he's a homosexual, and that the pod that they're supposed to be putting him in, they ain't having that. So he said he wants to get moved to the other pod, or he wants to get moved to PC. He claimed, the officer asked him if he wants to get moved to PC. So there's a lot of debate going on, you know, everybody making it, since it's King Von, everybody got all the excuses in the book whether or not he's really homosexual.
And I get it. By the way, I want to say this real fast. I understand it, because he's a local legend in Chicago. If this was Nipsey, niggas on the West Coast would be making the same excuses.
Right. Yeah, no, that's a fact. So I'm gonna play this quick clip here. And we'll see what King Von had to say.
I must say, no, go ahead and play it, then I'll give my commentary.
Yeah, on. No, go ahead.
No, I wanna wait till the video play to say this. So okay. Yeah, go ahead and do your thing, man. I definitely gotta say this, man. Nigga, it might not be the most friendly commentary, but you know, get my thoughts.
Okay, all right. Let's get this.
Them my pinches.
What's Ackerman doing?
Let's stop it right here, and let's just be clear. This is King Von.
Nah, definitely. 100%.
Everybody.
100%.
Well, then, I mean, I don't think anybody's really debating that, but we're just so we make sure it's clear.
100%.
That's him. Is King Von.
100%.
Them my pitches.
What's Ackerman doing?
Bro, could you please get my pitch from that man?
Where's the plumber at? In there?
It's the only deck I've been on with this. Got a problem, man. They supposed to be a Christian deck, but they got a problem with gay people. How you gonna be Christian?
So because of your sexual orientation, you're requesting protective custody, is that correct?
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. It gets worse. Woo! It gets worse.
Even his voice, that's definitely King Von. That's his voice, nigga. Like that.
Battle, Josh.
This nigga blowing kisses.
Fuck you too.
Wait, hold on. You hear that? You hear that, Chuck?
Nah. What'd he say?
Hold on, hold on.
I'm gonna fuck you too.
Oh, I didn't know. He said, I'm gonna fuck you too. Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah. Oh,
handcuff him.
Nah, I didn't even notice that.
I'm gonna fuck you too.
It just gets worse. It gets worse though.
Oh my God.
But it gets worse though, Chucky.
Handcuff him.
No.
Get his ID so we can take him downstairs, start the PC process. Behind the back and pat him down too.
You talk to my sister? You talk to my sister? Tell her I say I love her. Tell her I'm probably gonna go to PC. Tell her I'm gonna go to PC probably. They trying to let me suck they dick.
Oh no! No! The legendary King Von.
They trying to let me suck they dick.
No, hold on, we gotta remix that shit. Hold on.
They trying to let me suck they dick.
No. No. On.
One more time for the people in the back.
They trying to let me suck they dick.
Nah, nigga. Nah, nigga. Nah!
It's King Von, man.
That's crazy.
Y'all got room
That's
over
there? Crazy.
Y'all got room over
there? That guy just gave it to me for my pretend is that that's his stuff.
So, in short, that's what happened with him with Whoa. That video. I mean, the rest of that, they end up walking him down the hall and all that. So, but yeah. Go ahead.
I just think, bro, it's so first of all, because I haven't researched this too much, but I know a lot of niggas was justifying it, saying that he pretending to be gay, whatever. Okay, worst case scenario, why is this nigga going to PC? That's the crazy part. Even if he's faking the gay, we could give him that. Why is King Von going to PC?
That's the whole, like, that's the
why
main
is
thing
he
that
going to PC?
is the problem for the people who actually, like, see what's going on here. They're like, why is it that he's going to PC? Regardless of how he did it, how he chose, because there's plenty of ways that you could get yourself moved, but he chose to go that route. So, I mean, we hear about
He didn't even have to do the excessive gay shit. Just say you gay, and boom, you don't got to do. Oh, he let me such a did it. I ain't even gonna say it. But you know what I'm saying? You don't got to say the extras.
He was trying to, he was putting extras on it. And it's like, why would you? That's what makes me, like, when I watch that video, it makes me like, I think you probably were, you was a little funny in there. Cause it's like,
it was a little zesty in there.
You did a little too much. You didn't have to do all that.
Even his gestures, the little, I feel like,
when he was waving it. Yeah, when he was waving. Bye, little Josh.
Come on!
Bye, little Josh.
No!
Like, nah, if you was acting too well.
Nah, exactly.
You was acting too well.
Exactly.
And it's like the fact that you wasn't gonna get put, you wasn't doing that to get put in another pod with your homies. You was doing that to get PC. The officer asked you if you wanted to get PC. So that fucks up the whole that fucks up the whole situation for him. So it's like
that's all
I don't know, man. They're claiming, and that's not to take away from, and not to say that it's a good thing or it's good accolades, but that's not to take away from his gangster or whatever people want to say, or he was or any of that. But he was just on that funny shit. It's kind of fucked up, which is gonna bring me to my next clip.
I have a different take real quick before you play the clip. Mm-hmm. I just want to say that as a civilian, and I know real gangsters disagree with this 100%, but as a civilian, I look at this shit as if you put it in work, your sexual orientation don't matter. So I'm pretty sure this nigga was still a wild boy, but the gay shit, to me, that don't take away from the shit you did in the streets, nigga. You still a crazy nigga. But I know some gangsters will be like, nah, nigga, you's a bitch. Like, you gay. That discredits all the gangster shit you did. But yeah, go ahead and continue.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. At the end of the day, that's what it is. It's like we don't really care about the whole sexual orientation thing. It's more so about the PC situation with him involving him. Yeah. And like you said, like we ain't involved in none of that, and we ain't from Chicago anyway, so it doesn't really matter to us whether or not he's PC or not. If you like his music, like we said before in other videos, you like his music. But it's just like I was saying also before, like this industry is unraveling. It's revealing itself for what 100%. It really is, and the people that these people that you know they you know these. Fans look up to and these kids look up to, they're being exposed for not being what they're saying, what they're claiming to be. Mm-hmm. And I think that's the problem, is that people are lying about who they are.
Sure.
And you're not giving people the ability to like you for the artist that you are.
Agreed. And I always say this, bro, like from the get-go, look, you can rap gangster, you can rap if that's what's giving you, making you money, like, and let like, I don't care what the morality is of making your bread, nigga, but say that, bro. Be like, hey, like, there's some artists, like, what's his name? Slim, the white boy Slim Shady, but what's his name? Something. I don't know. It's a little white boy came from out of the Midwest. I forgot his name. Slim something. But anyways, this nigga has said it, like, nigga, I don't live this lifestyle. And he still.
Oh, you talking about Slim Jesus.
Slim Jesus.
Back in the day, the one that came out, it was like, yeah, he was like,
he has spoke verbally, I mean, publicly about, hey, this is all for entertainment. I'm not really that nigga. And I say, do that if you're not that nigga. But you know, everybody got to live this facade. I don't know why, my nigga, but it is what it is.
Yeah, no, definitely. They all are trying to portray this. I mean, I think that's where, like I said, that's where it becomes dangerous. That's where it becomes a problem, where, you have the fans and the kids who are listening to these artists, and they're trying to live what they're rapping about in the songs. But behind closed doors, these rappers are doing the complete opposite. They're snitching. They're getting beat up. They're getting fucked up.
It's crazy the amount of snitching that's going on. Oh my God, nigga, the industry is being. That's what I'm saying. I want to say this real quick before you play it, my nigga. For those of you that are fans of these artists, my nigga, please, and I said this many times, bro, please separate the music from the activity in which these artists participate in, bro. You know what I'm saying? Because you're going to be let down every time. These niggas do this for a bag. A lot of these niggas don't really live this lifestyle. So don't look at these niggas as idols and try to imitate what they portray in the music, bro, because you're going to set yourself up for failure every time. These niggas ain't even living it, bro. Most of them. Some of them is. But I separate it, bro. Sure. Separate it. Yeah.